The Tao of Self-Confidence, Episode 683.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have a phenomenal lady on the show today. She's a stunt woman, and I'm really excited to have her on and share her story with us today on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Tara Macken. Tara, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to the listeners.
Hi guys, I'm Tara, and I've been doing stunts for film and television for approximately like the last 10 years, but I've been a performer and been kind of an adventure seeker and a little thing, I think outside the box ever since I was a little kid. So that's kind of me in a nutshell.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Tara, what's your cultural background?
So I'm Filipino and Irish, and I actually grew up all over the world, but primarily in Brunei, Kuwait, and the Philippines, and now I live in Los Angeles. So definitely a lot of Filipino, a lot of Asian influences.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
My favorite self-confidence quote, let me see. I guess for me, and it's always been something that resonated with me ever since I was a little kid, is that the thing is, like, no matter what you want to do in life, you just need to, I know it sounds cheesy, you just need to believe in yourself, because quite frankly, nobody else will until you do. And so if you're always looking for approval of other people to make sure that the dream you want is okay, it's never going to happen. You just have to know if that's something you want to do, then you're going to go for it, because everyone's going to doubt you for a very long time until, you know, you get to where you are in your life that makes you happy and successful. So it's really important to just believe in yourself no matter what ridiculousness that can be and if everybody thinks you're crazy.
Thanks for sharing that. I totally agree. I mean, it has to start with that belief in yourself and you're going to go out there and have the confidence to take action no matter what happens. So thanks for sharing that. And in your own words, how do you define self-confidence?
Self-confidence is love. And I think it's being truthful and honest to your love of just what for like your passion. And once you believe in that, it just makes you, I don't know, for me, it just makes me happy, really. Like, and also I just feel like a lot of people, they have tendencies to be their worst critic and to always judge everything you do. And I think, you know, since you're living your own life, you have to be your number one cheerleader for yourself, so as opposed to always thinking about how things could be better. You should also think about how you succeeded in every little obstacle and every little task, and that will build your self-confidence. So, you know, every day you can be like, oh, this could have been better, or this performance could have, this gag could have done, I could have done better in this gag, or there's always things you can doubt yourself. But once again, it goes back to believing in yourself and knowing that, hey, you know what, sometimes what I did wasn't that good, but you know what, everything else I did was pretty damn great, and it's going to get better. And I can learn from the thing that wasn't so good.
Thanks for sharing that. I totally agree. I think we are our own worst critics, right? And even though if you think something you did was terrible, like other people sometimes see it as like, you did amazing, right? It's just because we're such like critics of ourselves that we don't see what other people see. So I think like that's something that I've noticed, right? Like if I say, oh, I did terrible, someone else would be like, you did amazing. And sometimes this kind of helps us kind of build our confidence. It's not as bad as we think it is, right? So I really love that definition that you mentioned. And Tara, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
You know, it's kind of weird. I've always felt like I've been kind of like a confident kid, and I've always actually been more on the confident side. And I think for me, I knew even growing up that everyone's different, and what makes everybody special isn't what makes us all unique. I mean, isn't what makes us all unified, is what makes us unique. So even when I was a little kid, like when I went to school back in the Philippines in high school and middle school, you know, I used to be part of like a dance company, I used to do gymnastics and play a lot of sports. And then I used to do like a lot of commercials and all that kind of work back then too. And I remember like, well, I was never like the prettiest one in the room for when I went to an audition. I was never the most talented one in the room, right? And I used to be intimidated a lot by everybody else who would show up. Like even when I went to a competition, I wasn't the most talented at the floor routine, right? So when you know, first of all, you never think about the competition because there's always going to be competition. You kind of just have to, I think just kind of growing up and realizing that there's always going to be somebody ahead of you, somebody behind you, and you are where you are. And so I think it was kind of a growing thing of you can't, once again, going back to the, you can't blame yourself or be hard on yourself. And it kind of builds your confidence knowing that, you know what, I can, all I can do is be the best version of me and then appreciate where I am, like in life. And then also knowing like, great, so I have other people who are better than me in these things. Now they give you a goal to like reach to and aspire to, right? So I think that kind of helped me grow into self-confidence and just understanding that, you know, you're great no matter what. Especially when I was younger, the Philippines, like growing up over there, I remember when I used to go to commercials, auditions and everything, it was really in vogue back then to like lighten your skin. Like the whiter you are, the prettier you are, right? Same thing. You have to have like pencil straight hair. And I used to think like, no, you know what? I like to just be kind of dark and weird looking and curly hair. I used to purposely go to castings, not like what the casting breakdown would say. I would just go in just like myself because I'm like, you know what? I'm pretty awesome as is. And if you want me to look a certain way, well, that's not me. I can only look the way I can look. And if you like it, awesome. And if you don't, that's just too bad on you.
Thanks for sharing that. You know, I totally agree. Like, I'm from the Philippines as well. And like, you know, the amount of skin whitening products you see is insane, right? And, you know, that standard of beauty needs to be taken away and realize like you're beautiful in every like color, right? It doesn't matter what skin tone you are, just show up as yourself. And, you know, it's funny, like when I go to the Philippines and they see me all tan, they're like, why are you so dark? What's wrong with you? Like, it's not pretty. But for me, it's like, you know, this is who I am, right? I mean, you know, I like to tan. So for me, it's like, it's not a big deal. But for other people, like they see it as something different. But we just have to realize, like, it doesn't matter, you know, if you're pale skin, if you're dark skin, if you're in the middle, you're still beautiful no matter what. So I really love that you mentioned that and brought that up. And, you know, what was that point in your life when you realized, especially like becoming a stunt woman, right? I'm pretty sure a lot of people think like, you know, that's so crazy. Why would you do that? It's so dangerous, especially as a woman, right? What was that aha moment that made you realize like you can go out there and be a stunt woman?
Well, as you know, coming from the Philippines, you know, they have all the best intentions for you. They want you to do something good and safe and that betters the community, right? So either A, you're a doctor or a nurse, or B, you're a singer. That's kind of how that kind of went. So for me, it was kind of helpful to go to the States for college and just kind of do my own thing without having, you know, my whole family just being like, what are you doing every single 5 minutes? And when I was transitioning into doing stunts and action, I just kind of put under the guise like, oh, I'm acting. And then before you knew it, then I got more stunt work and everything. And then my family's all like, oh, it's so dangerous. Oh my God, when are you going to stop that? That's crazy. But now what I do, I just show them my safer looking stunts. And if I have some gnarly, crazy stunts, I don't show them the process until way after when they can watch in a movie theater. And they actually had no idea how the whole process went down. And I think the aha moment for me, I remember when I graduated college, I was a political science major and a theater major. I remember my dad asked me, oh, so what are you going to do now? And I told him, I was like, well, Dad, it's going to be a surprise, but it's going to be great. So give me like 5 years and I'll tell you what I'm going to do. So yeah, that's kind of my aha moment.
Thanks for sharing then. I think it's, you know, it's crazy, right? Sometimes like, we just kind of have to hide what we're doing until like we prove that like it can be done. Because I know sometimes like the noise from family members, and I know they do it out of love, like sometimes it kind of distracts us from going after what we want. And sometimes you just need to like put the blinders on and just do it, right? Without any distractions. And once you have that proof, you can be like, you know, here it is. You know, I am well taken care of, you know, I'm good. I'm still healthy. I'm still in good shape. I'm still in one piece. And, you know, it's possible. So I'm really glad you're able to share that. And, you know, because of those realizations, what's your life been like now?
It's been great. It's been, you know, it took them a couple years to come around to the idea. So even though I was a working, successful stunt woman for them, they still didn't really understand the concept. And so I used to see them and they used to still ask me the question, so when are you gonna just, you know, quit and do something else? Because they just thought it was like a side thing. Like, okay, so when are you gonna, you know, do something like real, right? It's been really awesome. It's been really fulfilling knowing that I'm kind of in this place where, you know, I'm doing what I love. I'm doing something that I know I'm good at, you know, and I've grown to be really good at it. And now that I've reached this level of success where, you know, I don't really have people in my family questioning my every move or motive. Instead, they're like, oh my God, you should be more like your tita. You know, like, oh my God, you know, I got like a new nephew and a new niece. And like, oh, one day you'll be a stunt woman like her. So now it's like the new thing. And I'm like, huh, do you want your kid to fall down a flight of stairs? I don't think so. But I'm glad that at least now I can be kind of an inspiration for these little kids. That's pretty cool.
Awesome. I think that's great. I mean, you know, I'm pretty sure when you first started, it was the total opposite. And it's kind of crazy what happens, right? When you can just show up and just, you know, do what you love, like the results are like crazy, right? So I think that's great. And, you know, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey to self-confidence. What would be that one tip you'd give to her?
Start off small and be kind to yourself, like whatever that may be. I've had a lot of friends that I remember when I graduated college, you know, it's kind of like, I'm just going to do what I love to do. And I don't care. I'm just going to try my darn hardest to do it now while I can. Right. Meanwhile, I had my other friends who graduated with me and they're like, well, I really want to do this, but I just got this internship at this like tech company doing like whatever. So I'm going to do this because it's my first job and they're paying me and it's like a solid thing. Right. And remember in our 20s, they kind of stayed at that job and at that position. Meanwhile, I was kind of growing my brand and growing my passion for action and stunts of filmmaking and what I really wanted to do. And when you approached like our 30s, there was kind of like what I like to call a quarter life crisis, where I was finally at a place where I felt really proud of my work and feel very validated for doing something I love. And I've actually, you know, spent 10 years of my life trying to hone it. Meanwhile, my friends are just like, who decided to go with the first company that offered them a job. We're just kind of like, oh my God, I'm having this crisis because I want to quit and I want to start over. And I just realized it's been the last, you know, 10 years of my life since uni doing something because it was a paycheck, but I freaking hate it. But now I feel like I'm too old to start again doing something I actually wanted to do, like open up a bakery, per se. You know, so I say, just whatever you can, do what you love and just do it small to start with. And if you're scared of taking a risk, don't tell anybody. Just do it for yourself. If you can't handle the pressure of people just always asking why you're doing things, they're usually asking because they're scared themselves and they're scared for you too, because that's something completely out of their character and they wouldn't do it. So they can't fathom why you would do it. So take small steps like to the victory of your to your future. And I think it will pay off immensely. And if anything, it'll make you feel a whole lot better and a little bit more confident that every day you're doing something that betters yourself. It doesn't better your brother or your sister or your kids or your mother or your dad. You're doing it for yourself and you're allowed to. It's your own life. So you should be proud and just know that you're doing it primarily because you want to. So, and then also I remember there was this analogy I saw somebody once said, you know, when you're on a plane and the plane's going to go down and you have the oxygen mask that comes down, you have to put the oxygen mask on yourself first before you can help anybody else, right? So this should be applied to just your daily life. If you're always considering other people's safety and security and happiness, but you're ignoring your own calling, then you're not helping them either. So lead by example, help yourself first. And once you can do that, then, and once that happens, you can inadvertently help other people just even by example.
Thanks for sharing those great tips. And I totally agree. You know, a lot of people feel like they have to make big leaps to build confidence, but it really just starts with the small steps. And the, you know, the more you build your self-confidence, like little by little, it does yield that big result that you want, right? So I think that's great that you mentioned that and the analogy with the mask, because yeah, you know, we have to learn to help ourselves first before we can help others. So thanks for sharing those great tips. And if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do or check out some of your work, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Sure. I mean, you can just check me out on my Instagram. So that's just at Tara Macken. I'm on IMDb and Facebook, but I don't really use those things. I'm just more like on the Insta life.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Tara, you can also head on over to thetaleofselfconfidence.com and search for Tara's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else that we talked about. And I really just want to thank Tara today for taking the time to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Tara.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for having me. It was a lot of fun.
Not a problem. It was really great having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.
All right. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Get your free audiobook by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.